tell us about your background.
Yes, I was born in a wonderful little town in Haddonfield, New Jersey. The town was, it's actually a bedroom community of Philadelphia. It's 6 miles from Philadelphia. So I did, while growing up in a suburb, I did grow up near a big metropolis, which had museums and art schools, and I was exposed to that at a very young age, which, of course, helped direct the course that I chose to take my life. John, Ryan, Wally, Hedrick, David Simpson, Hayward King, Jack Spicer, and I got together and said, why don't we take over the gallery? Why don't we try running a gallery on some cooperative basis? So we did. And there were six of us, five artists, we were students, and our teacher, Jack Spicer, was the poet. We opened and we founded and opened now the well-known Six Gallery. But I wanted to do something that was strictly mine, and being a kind of maverick, I wouldn't settle for anything less until I found what was very meaningful to me. At that point, I realized there were two roads I could take, which I have done. The first road I took for the next 20 years, from 63 to 1983, is the work by which I'm probably best known. I balance through an asymmetrical concept. Big journey for me, and it still is. So I had a lot of fun with this. Having the painting balanced through the concept of imbalance or disequilibrium. equilibrium through disequilibrium. Artists should always remember, your vision is the most primary. It's the thing that makes the work interesting. It's not the technique. Mm-hmm. So the technique should always follow the vision. If the vision changes, then the technique should change. Well, where do I get my names? I get them from the pronouncing gazetteer in the back of the dictionary. I also get them from Latin. And I also make up words. So my palette is really pretty simple. It consists of black and white, three yellows, cad yellow, light, medium, and dark, cad orange, cadmium red, medium, and dark, alizarin crimson, Prussian blue, cobalt blue, that's it. So that as I grow and move and change through life, so does my work. It mirrors who I am at the time. I mean, you have to paint for yourself. Make something from nothing. Mm-hmm. How do you do that? It's alchemy. You make something from nothing. You take very limited materials and very limited black and white. That's pretty limited. Mm-hmm. How do you make it sing? For me, painting is always a road, it's a journey. Mm-hmm.